The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed to view foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For in the eyes of men, indeed, they will be punished. It is their hopeful immortality. Chastised a little, they should be greatly blessed, because by God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in a furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way. Thomas said to him, Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. Baptism. And that baptism after the garment us from sin and death. We give thanks and praise to Almighty God for all the good that he did in Jean's life. We see evidence of a marriage 60-some years. We see bringing up the children through Holy Redeemer practice. She was involved with the Sodali Women's Club here. She was involved with with charitable causes and involved with Bingo, which helps support Catholic schools. She had signs of the Lord Jesus Christ in her life. She was told she was a parishioner before this church was even built. So it's people like her that keep this place going, keep this place alive and active. So these are signs of God's goodness in her life, signs that God was at work. So we give praise to God for that. The second thing we do at funerals is, of course, we pray. And yes, we pray for all the family and friends who mourn. But even more importantly, most importantly, we actually continue to pray for Jean. Her Catholic faith taught her, teaches us to pray for the dead. Why? Because the Lord Jesus says that we must be perfect, like our Heavenly Father is perfect. And heaven is a place of perfection. And so while Jean loved the Lord Jesus Christ, she did so imperfectly, just like the rest of us. We're not perfect. And so when we leave here on this earth and we die in God's friendship, there's a period where we need to be perfected and we're stripped of anything we're kind of clinging on to and holding on to. It's that place of perfection, what we call purgatory. It's a place of hope. It's heaven's waiting room. And then once we're perfected, the gates of heaven are open for us and we're there for eternity. So we pray that God have mercy on Jean, and we pray that the perfection goes as quickly as possible. And the third thing we do at funerals is we prepare. We all must be prepared. Today is a reminder of how thin the veil is between this life and the next. 1 minute we're here, the next minute we're not. Are you prepared? Is Jesus Christ the center of my life? Or is Jesus Christ maybe on the periphery? I'll reach out to him, I want something, need something. But is he truly the center? We're called always, today especially, to bring Jesus Christ to the center of our lives. When we give our lives over to Jesus Christ, we have nothing to lose, absolutely nothing to lose, but everything to gain. I know at every funeral there's always people who somehow, someway drifted. It happens. It's part of life sometimes. So I invite you on behalf of Almighty God, on behalf of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, who's doing wonderful things in the church, to come back. To come back home. This is your home. The church is your home. Fulton Sheen, Archbishop Fulton Sheen, who probably one day be a saint here very soon, he said that no one hates the church, but many people hate what they wrongly perceive the church to be. I think Pope Francis is doing a good job of trying to clear things up, trying to say there's a lot of misperceptions out there of what the church is. almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one and all he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Mercy on us all people. bless the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. We may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. May praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you. length of what you submit, and then they have a series of things that they ask, such as positions held, you know, careers, contributions. And so I was quickly picking up on the fact that they want something that's newsworthy. You know, they want something that's going to sell the newspaper. They want something that's going to be kind of special and fabulous, maybe extreme, I don't know. And I'm not so sure that anything that my mom really did, that our mom really did, fits their criteria for something that's newsworthy. She didn't drive fancy cars. She didn't really have any special jobs or anything like that. I think the fanciest car she probably ever drove was a 1966 Country Squire, if I'm not mistaken. But so then I started thinking, right. My mom needs recognition. So then I started thinking, well, maybe I could fabricate something. Maybe I could go ahead and just, you know, not make anything up, but just embellish a little bit, perhaps. And so, upon witnessing what we witnessed on Mother's Day, as our family attended to her side, I think we saw a pretty close to her. Mom, what do you think of Donald Trump? And she proceeded to say, I say that, she would play 3 to 4 times a week. And there was a point in time when it was twice up here at the school. But then she would go to Bethesda Chief Rescue Squad, where they played, and she would attend different churches and so forth. And it was not unusual for mom to win. And she won a lot. And that's not an exaggeration. For her to come home with hundreds of dollars, it was common. It was frequent. And it was not unusual. So she gambled.
that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Jean in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant, and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest. Gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. We commit her body to its resting place, for we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his.